getting the error 0x80370102, the virtual machine could not be started because a required feature is not installed while starting Windows subsystem for Linux on your Windows computer. Here are four ways you can fix it. This is the Windows Club. Windows subsystem for Linux requires Hyper-V and virtualization enabled to be used on a computer. Assuming you have mistakenly disabled one of the features on your computer, even after enabling Windows subsystem for Linux, you could get this error while starting WSL on your PC. Here we have shown how you can fix it. Let's get started. Method 1. The first thing you need to do is enable Hyper-V. Click on the taskbar search box. Type turn Windows features on or off. Click on the individual search result. Find out Hyper-V. Tick the corresponding checkbox. Click the OK button. Let it finish the installation. Restart your computer. Method 2. In order to use the Hyper-V powered Windows subsystem for Linux on your PC, you need to turn on the hardware virtualization. If you have mistakenly disabled it after installing WSL, you need to check and enable this feature from the BIOS. Before that, you can open the Task Manager on your computer and switch to the Performance tab. Here, you can find a label called Virtualization. Make sure that the status is showing Enabled. If not, you will need to enable it. We have a detailed guide on how to do it for various motherboards, so check it out. Method 3. If you have installed Windows subsystem for Linux on a virtual Windows machine, you need to turn on the nested virtualization. Depending on which virtual machine software you use, the steps might be different. However, almost all the popular virtual machine tools come with a similar option to enable nested virtualization. Method 4. Virtual machine platform is another mandatory feature you need to enable in order to fix the error 0x80370102 while starting the Windows subsystem for Linux. Search for Turn Windows Features On or Off in the taskbar search box. Click on the search result. Find out Virtual Machine Platform option. Tick the corresponding checkbox. Click the OK button and let the installation be completed. Reboot your computer. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.